एज इज जस्ट अ नंबर, ये कहावत तो आप सबने सुनी होगी। वॉट मैटर इज नॉट हाउ ओल्ड यू आर बट हाउ मच लाइफ इज देयर इन योर ईयर्स। और जैसा आप सोचते हैं वैसे ही बन जाते हैं। इन फैक्ट देयर वॉज अ रिसर्च विच वॉज कंडक्टेड एंड इट वॉज फाउंड इफ यू फील यंग यू एक्चुअली लुक यंग। And on that positive note, I would like to welcome the guest on our show who not only just looks beautiful but also looks much, much younger than her age. She's the one who believes in living life queen size. In fact, it's just last week that she won the title of Mrs. Confident at the Mrs. West India 2020 Beauty Pageant. Now, this is something incredible which you or I haven't heard before. So before I welcome her on the show, let me urge you to subscribe to our channel and be the part of our growing community. Hello Anjalika ji, congratulations for winning that crown. You did it. How are you doing?
Hi Sadaf, so good to see you. Thank you so much for inviting me for your Women's Influencer talk show. I really love the initiative you have taken and the kind of work and the connection with people you are doing. I really, really appreciate that. Thank you for inviting me over. So let me not give you a cliche answer that I'm wonderful, I'm doing good. Rather, I would give you an answer how I'm feeling right now is like I am feeling rewired. So I'm probably going to have a tattoo also which says rewired. So rewired in terms of the way lockdown has treated me. Now lockdown has created a new me, I should say, because I feel that the way I feel, the way I think, the way I look, the way I vibrate on a frequency which is a happy and a high frequency, I do feel that I am rewired completely, in capital.
All right, so let's know more about you from you.
So I begin with my name Anjalika. It means blessings of God. But I was not born with this name. You know, my father named me after then famous Usha fans. Can you believe it? He had sold maximum number of Usha fans that year. And so he named me Usha. So I was born in Banaras, a city of Nirvana. And that's why probably I keep looking at small Nirvanas in life. Maybe in a small piece of cake. Maybe in a small bunch of red roses. Or maybe in a small glass of white wine. And yes, choti choti khushiyan.
Wo kehte hai na, when you are thankful for little things, even those little things are no more little. So let's hear something about your childhood.
So I was born in a very humble Sindhi family where I had a very stereotypical mother who was only interested in me getting married and my progressive father who believed that education is passport to the future. And that's why, especially for girls, he felt like that. And so, he believed in that and he followed that.
That's great. You know, the behavior of an individual depends on what type of parenting has been done. Uski parvarish kaisi hui hai, how he has been brought up. So, as you mentioned that your mother was pretty inclined towards your getting married early, how did you pursue your studies in medicines? Because that takes a lot of time and years.
Oh, that's because of my father and his wondrous thought process. You know, Sadaf, being a child, eldest in the family, I noticed one thing that my mother used to pick on me to do all the household chores. And I used to hate that. I had four siblings and nobody used to do anything. Okay, so I used to carry my storybooks, put them in the study books and used to at least act to study. And while in that process, I realized that whenever I study, my mom never used to disturb me. And so I continued with my fake studies and real studies and I became a good student. And so my father had a vision for me. And he wanted me to be a doctor. But Sadaf, I never wanted to be a doctor. I wanted to be a journalist or a writer. But then he had a vision for me. And you know, as we are younger, we understand what our parents go through as far as the financial struggles are concerned, the social pressures are concerned. And we all think that our fathers are our Superman. And as we grow older, we realize, you know, they are normal human beings. They are regular people, but they wear a cape. So my Superman, he sent me to a medical college to study MBBS, to Pune Vijay Medical College. And that's how I became a doctor.
That's great. But how did you get into poetry? Were there authors and poets in your family who inspired you?
Oh, poetry is in my genes, I think. I think I remember my father, when he was 45 years old, he was studying Hindi poetry and literature in a distant learning program. Now it is so easy to learn online, but he did that time. And then when he used to practice his poetry and verses, he used to make me sit and listen to it. And that is the time I realized the power of words and the kind of emotions it evoked in me. And I got fascinated by it. I started writing also. And as I grew older, I was fascinated by Gulzar Sahab, totally inspired by Gulzar Sahab. I remember I had written one of the poems in the overcrowded local trains. And that's how my journey started. And then I became a writer. I became a professional writer with the Banyan Tree Communications. I wrote radio plays for them. I adapted Ramayana and Mahabharata for them. I wrote some fictional stories also for them. So my dream of becoming a writer got completed.
क्या बात है अंजुलिका जी. You know, people who follow their passion and also have the spirit of never give up are those people who are always happy, and आपकी मुस्कुराहट के पीछे भी शायद यही राज है. Here I would like to tell the viewers that Anjulika ji was unstoppable. After finishing her studies in medicine, she went on to do documentary filmmaking. Now isn't that amazing? So as a practicing doctor, was it difficult for you, Anjulika ji?
My God, Sadaf, you have done such a good research. I must say, in the time of test, family is the best. By now you know that I am a happy soul, but I am also a very restless soul. And my family also knew that. My ever supportive husband, Dr. Suresh, and my pretty daughters, Neha and Reema, they always knew that I'm a movie holic. I can watch movies any time of the day. And in those days, I developed a fascination to make documentary films, autobiographical documentary films, of very, very regular people, not the celebrities. Because I feel every regular person has a story to tell. You just need to go a little deeper into that. If I have to say it in a poetry form, I can say, हम सबकी कहानी एक जैसी ही होती है. हम सबकी कहानी एक जैसी ही होती है. लम्हों का सफर तो सबका वही होता है. सिर्फ यादों के स्टेशन अलग अलग होते हैं. And to do that, I had to go to Pune, FTII, to learn the documentary filmmaking. But the decision was very, very tough for me because I had to shut down my practice for 2 months and then go there. But then that's the time your family stands by you. So my family stood by me and let me go and finish my course there. I did that. I came back. I did some around 20 documentaries, autobiographical documentaries. And now if my story is to be told, it has to be cinematic, right?
Oh yes, totally. What sets you apart is your ability to take risk and also the courage that you portray. Kyunki vulnerability to hum sabhi mein hoti hai, but research batati hai that we dare more greatly when we acknowledge fears. And I think that is your success mantra. Now there was also another shift in your career when you moved from medical practice to cosmetology. Why this shift?
Yes, Sadaf. Beauty is illumination of soul. And if your skin looks beautiful, you eliminate more. So cosmetology offers hope. And that's why I quit my medical practice to come in cosmetology. Also, because nowadays in this generation or older generation, because of the social pressure or social media pressure, I should say, everybody wants to look young, everybody wants to look beautiful. And so cosmetology offers hope for them and solutions for them. And that's how I wanted to offer that hope in the hearts of people. And in that process, I also upgrade my knowledge. I know about new technologies. So I got associated with Kaya Skin Clinic for 10 years. I have won some awards also there about Kaya values and business contribution. So yes, so whenever I do a treatment and if I offer a dream skin to my client, I give a hope. And in that process, that illuminates my soul.
ट्रू, उम्मीद पे तो दुनिया कायम है, एंड आई थिंक व्हाट यू डू इज नॉट ओनली गिव पॉजिटिविटी टू योर पेशेंट्स बट ऑल्सो द कॉन्फिडेंस दैट यू गिव टू देम. आई थिंक दैट्स जस्ट इनक्रेडिबल. टुडे वी हैव डॉक्टर संगीता विलास्कर ऑन आवर शो, हु इज द मेडिकल हेड एट काया स्किन केयर क्लिनिक. लेट्स सी व्हाट शी हैज टू से फॉर यू.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sangeeta Velaskar. I've known Angelica for the last 10 years. She's worked with me as a very integral part of my medical team. What do I say about Angelica? Her energy, her positivity, her smiles, her laughter. Truly, she can influence anyone to live life fully, with integrity and with charm. She's such a wonderful person at heart, and she's also truly ageless. I wish her all the best in life.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sangeeta, and I second that. Angelica ji is definitely an ageless beauty, and so is her charm. Now coming back to you, Angelica ji, another feather in your cap was when you entered the beauty pageant. How and why?
Just happened by impulse. You know, I'm an impulse, I act on my impulse. My acting coach, Saurabh Sachdeva, who's the guy who played Isha Bhai in Sacred Games, he'll be so happy to know this. Because he taught us how to be in impulse. But that's not the only reason. The main reason to enter into the beauty pageant is the words, Die Empty, uttered by my now mentor, Karl Mascarenhas. He told us a story about dying empty. So whenever you die, you empty your heart of your desires, your dreams and your creativity. And that was the profound moment, the goosebumpish moment for me. And I took the decision to be part of this beauty pageant.
Die Empty by Todd Henry is a book that talks about leaving this world bereft of all the creativity, all the positivity that is within you. When we met Angelica, the girl radiates so much of positivity that I'm quite confident once she leaves a mark in a beauty pageant, she will leave this world, and we'll have to retitle the book not Die Empty, but Die Fulfilled. Karl Mascarenhas, cheers Angelica, bye.
Yes, Diva Pageants is a platform for married ladies of any age, maybe 59. To dare, to dream, and to dazzle.
59? Did I hear it right? But then, of course, we are talking about you, and you are ageless and also unstoppable. Now, let me ask you a very, very important question. There are various people who attach stereotypic notion about who can enter a beauty pageant and who cannot. What do you have to say about that?
Sadab, I entered into the pageant with impulse. But now, it is a purpose. See, nowadays everybody talks about body positivity, mind positivity, but nobody talks about beauty positivity. Feeling positive with the beauty what God has given you. We keep criticizing our own beauty. And so now I want people to develop an attitude of beauty, that is beautitude, in your heart, mind and soul. And the steps are very simple. Number one step is self-acceptance. Accept the way you are, no matter what age, what color, what size, and the self-love which will follow. So once you accept these two things in your life, your beautitude will radiate from within you. And then when you stand in front of a mirror, there will be somebody special smiling back to you. And that is a beautitude. There's a famous saying that beauty lies in the eyes of beholder, but it will be very liberating to say that you become the beholder and feel beautiful. See, there is one thing in Indian society which bothers us or bogs us down is sabse bada rog kya kahenge log. Just get over that. Do your best skincare, do your best of diet and nutrition. And leave rest to the God and feel beautiful. Develop an attitude of beautitude. And if you have trouble with that, I'm just a phone call away. Call me.
That's very encouraging, Anjulika ji, and that is so much of assurance that we are getting from you. Now, I would like to ask you a question which most of the viewers would like to ask you personally. There are a lot of viewers who are watching this show and I think they want to ask you this question. After a certain age, people are very skeptical about pursuing their passion. What advice would you like to give to them?
Oh, one advice. Own it. Own your dreams. Own your convictions. Own your passions. Own your imperfections. Just own your story. And when you own something, no society, no person, nobody can take it away from you. And whatever you believe in, just believe it, believe it, believe it. Even if you don't believe it. Somebody said, play the game of belief and the universe will follow. So just own your story, believe in yourself and live your life.
Very well said. And you know, I read somewhere that even though you cannot control your circumstances, if you can control your thoughts, I think there is nothing that can stop you. Now, knowing you, is there something which is there still left in your bucket list?
Sada, for me, it won't be a bucket list. It will be a barrel list. The number one in the list will be a day in the life of Shah Rukh Khan. So I would like to spend my one day as Shah Rukh Khan because I feel his life is so magical and I'm his big fan and who is not? So I would like to spend a day in the life of Shah Rukh Khan as Shah Rukh Khan. Then of course, I definitely want to do one ultra glam photo shoot in Paris against the backdrop of Eiffel Tower. Can I go on?
Yes, yes, please go ahead. I'm super thrilled to know.
Then I definitely want to walk on the red carpet at Kodak Theatre for Oscars as a producer, maybe writer, maybe actor. You never know. Wearing this Hemant Trivedi gown. But at the end of the day, Sadaf, I feel if any book is written on my life or any film is made on my life, it should be titled, I am done, but not finished yet.
Superb. And all I can say is that I'm sure it's gonna be a blockbuster hit. And knowing you, definitely there is no second thoughts about it. You know, Anjulika ji, there are so many questions that are bombarding my brain, but then we have time constraint and we'll have to say goodbye to you. But lastly, before you go, what are your thoughts about our show?
Sadaf, Steve Jobs said once that people who are crazy enough to think that they can change the world, they are the ones are doing it. And that's how, through this small act of inspiration, you are bringing in a huge change slowly, slowly. You are inspiring lives globally. At Women's Influencer Show, you as a presenter have so much charm and you bring out the best in people. And the machinery which is doing research is so commendable. That you guys are giving such a beautiful, wonderful, informative, inspiring talk show. And this must go on because you are bringing in the change and we can already see it. So keep doing it. Keep inspiring.
Isn't that lovely to hear those words from you? I'm so honored and so delightful to have influencers like you on my show. Because although I'm an avid reader of motivational books, but what value you people give to my life is completely priceless. I'm so thankful that you came on my show and I hope the wishes in your bucket list or for that matter your barren list get fulfilled very soon. All the best in your life. Thank you once again. So before I say goodbye to all you beautiful people, let me remind you to subscribe to our channel. And hey, please don't forget to send us your questions. Our Ask the Expert series is going great and we are waiting for your questions. So till we meet next time again, take care, stay safe and be happy.